Hello, 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 and welcome to Learn English Live 7. Yes, lucky 7, and lucky me, as I have some fabulous questions from three fabulous ladies. My first question is from Evelina from Poland. Hello, Poland.
Hi, Steve. It's Evelina from Poland. I would like to ask about difference between whether and if, because I never know whether I should use whether or if.
Well, thanks for your question, Evelina. Many students have asked me this particular question, and I'm glad you asked. The confusion a lot of people have, and even native speakers have, about whether and if, is that in informal writing and in speech, they are often used interchangeably. For example, when they are used for yes or no questions. I don't know whether she'll be here by Sunday. I don't know if she'll be here by Sunday. Both of these sentences sound right for informal speech, but if you're doing a high level academic test like the GMAT, whether is preferred. The bottom line is, for grammarians, whether should be used for pointing out two possible options, while if should be used in conditional sentences. Now, let's look at how the meaning changes in the sentences. We don't know whether the meeting will be on Friday or Saturday. So in this sentence, the only doubt we have is the day the meeting will take place. But if we say we don't know if the meeting will happen on Friday or Saturday, the meaning is that we don't know if the meeting will take place at all. Sound confusing? Yes, big time. So I suggest, as a rule of thumb for your academic writing, that you use whether when you're talking about two options. You can use whether with prepositions. I haven't resolved the question of whether I will go back home. You could use or not, but often this is understood, and some schools nowadays consider it to be redundant. So be careful. I haven't resolved the question of whether or not I will go back home, or I haven't resolved the question of whether I will go back home or not. You can also use whether followed by infinitives. They can't decide whether to live together or not. You can also use whether at the beginning of a sentence. Whether the economic union can avoid a breakup or not is another matter. You can also use whether when dealing with a two-part question. Her boyfriend has not decided whether he will stay in New York or go back to Russia. Now, I know that a lot of you must be thinking, but I could use if in a lot of these sentences, and sounds good. And my answer is all about register, what I call the level of formality. So try to follow the basic rule of academic English versus informal English, and you should be fine. I should add that in a lot of languages, whether does not have an equivalent. So in many other languages, whether and if are the same thing and beyond the shadow of a doubt. This mixes up a lot of non-native speakers of English. My second question is from Ali from India, currently living in Washington, D.C.
Hey, Steve, this is Sonali from Washington, D.C. I'm originally from India. Ever since I moved to United States, I have been observing that communication skills is so important. It's really the key to success. I've been working, and now I'm looking forward to advance in my career. And I'm actually looking forward to take the TOEFL test. Today, I stumbled upon your website, and looks like it's going to help me a lot. However, I would also like to know if you are coming up with any new videos that can really help me in giving an edge to my TOEFL preparation. In the meantime, I got to tell you, you are doing such a wonderful job, and keep up the good job, Steve. Thanks.
Thanks for your question and compliment, Ali. I've helped a lot of people pass the TOEFL, and judging by your speaking, you have a good chance of getting a top score on the TOEFL test. So far, I've produced 18 videos for the TOEFL and IELTS, and I have some podcasts as well. My online TOEFL students are most worried about speaking and writing, and in some minor cases, the listening and reading sections. Basically, the students I get fall into two categories: those who have strong academic backgrounds and those who have strong general English backgrounds. The speaking has 6 questions which test students on academic lectures, conversations between students and or professors and university administrators. Choose a good TOEFL prep course or do self-study. Now, I get a lot of students who I call survivors of TOEFL preparation courses. The feedback I get from them is always the same: too much theoretical knowledge and not enough task-oriented practice. There are many books available to prepare for the TOEFL, and from what I can see, the level of difficulty for different sections may vary from the real test. Now, my next tip is check out the ETS speaking rubric, and I will leave a link below my video for that. It is important to get a good idea of how the raters view a different range of scores. And you can download a speaking section test, which has previous examinees and their scores, along with the ETS raters' comments on their performances. I mentioned this in the free version of my TOEFL podcast for focusing on pronunciation, success or success, word choice, discuss things with friends versus chat with friends, paraphrasing, the most important person to you, the person who means the most to me, cohesion of ideas, and of course, grammar. Well, Ali, I could go on about the TOEFL a lot more, but I know that less is more, and I try to give you information based on my teaching experience. Lastly, I'd like to share a message from Maria from Costa Rica. Costa Rica. First of all, thanks for your comment. Believe it or not, I read each and every comment as much as I can with all the time that I have. Steve, I was founding information. Here you want to say I was looking for about improve my English. Here you want to say to improve my English. Why do we use the infinitive here? Many times when you want to express your purpose, you can use the infinitive. So I am studying English to get a better job, or I am listening to music to cheer myself up. Next one is in internet, which should be on the internet. I am enjoying a lot your work should be I am enjoying your work a lot. And lastly, I like to say would be I would like to say. You that are extraordinary teacher, make sure you put an. I'd like to thank you all for sending me your questions here on Learn English Live 7. You are all more than welcome to record your question and send it to me at info@privateenglishportal.com. It gives you a chance to get up the courage to say something in English, while at the same time, to clear up your doubts about those things that might have been gnawing away at you for a long time. Have a great day and see you next time. Bye for now.